go. Welcome to another exciting episode of Super Desperation Radio. I am your sometimes host, sometimes voice in the background, Hell Pockets, of Arcade Shock descent, and other parts unknown. Other parts unknown, because only part of me is from Arcade Shock. The other parts are unknown.
Huh. Oh, this is sick. All right, cool. Just got a new talking point for the show, boys. Yeah.
Why do people ring doorbells at 6:30? Like, really?
Because, you know, they want to ring the doorbell so they can get your attention. They can be like, oh, yo, senpai noticed me because I rang the damn doorbell.
Just come up and like, hi, doorbell inspector. You're good.
Jesus. Don't people know I have things to do, important things?
Did they at least have a pizza?
No, it was just cat. She's picking up Steve's stick because he left it over here.
Why are cats coming to your place to pick up sticks?
I don't know, man.
It makes no sense. This has got to be a buff-ass cat to pick up a goddamn stick.
Yep. You never know.
Holy shit.
It's a very swole cat.
Yeah. You know, I can get behind swole cat. Yeah. I'm okay with that. Just watch your cat flex. Yeah, so how was everyone's Thanksgiving?
It was nice. Cool. It wasn't bad.
Lazy. I liked it. Liked everything about that. I don't think I did shit all weekend.
I didn't do shit on Thursday. We had leftovers, but it mysteriously disappeared and somehow ended up in my aunts and uncles' houses, so that kind of was a weird. But, you know, I couldn't eat all that anyway. And had the bomb-ass macaroni, and that put me down for 3 days.
That'll do it.
Anyway, yeah. What'd you do?
Ate a bunch of bad food. And
bad food?
Yeah, it wasn't really all that great. It was an odd Thanksgiving for us. Usually we don't make turkey. We don't do the traditional American style Thanksgiving. We just cook a shit ton of food. It doesn't matter what it is. And then we eat it. And this Thanksgiving, we made a fucking turkey and some other shit. This turkey was dry as hell.
Had no flavor to it. That sucks.
That's terrible. Usually, like, we make fried chicken and we do this other shit like roast beef and all this crap. Like, nah. People want a turkey because apparently that's the thing to do during Thanksgiving.
You know, you can just go to Arby's to get roast beef.
Whoa. I'm never thinking Arby's, though.
Yeah, so. Man. Don't you know they have the meats?
That's what I'm saying. They got the meats.
Oh, man. I don't even think we have an Arby's.
Who the hell thought that was a good slogan, by the way?
We got the meats.
Can we talk about that for a minute? Worst shit ever.
Like, literally, right? It is literally the worst shit ever. If you've ever had the meats, it is literally the worst shit you've ever had in your life.
Dog, I was on the toilet for 8 months.
I picked up the meats, man. I legit took a dump, and there was a meatloaf out of my butt.
Like, I'm thinking Arby's was perfect. Like, what happened?
Yeah, I don't know, man. I guess they weren't getting the response they wanted from it.
I guess.
Enough people weren't thinking Arby's. I don't see how they couldn't be. I don't know how you could have that slogan. And people, if anything, their reaction is, I'm thinking Arby's. That sounds dumb. Oh, shit, I am thinking Arby's.
Right, it's just catchy enough that it might work.
What else did they have to go for? It's not like they were doing anything else except backsliding.
I mean, their fucking mascot is a goddamn oven mitt. Come on.
Wait, Hamburger Helper?
It's basically Hamburger Helper.
They have a mascot?
Yeah, I was like, I just thought it was...
Oh, yeah, it is the oven mitt. Holy shit, this guy
is the glove, but this is just a damn oven mitt.
It's like the evil version of the Hamburger Helper.
Oh,
guy.
Yeah, this thing. Holy shit. Yeah.
Does it at least have the hat?
No.
So the hat is just totally not even necessary. They just put it on all the storefronts.
No, it's got the hat as an apron.
What?
It's got the hat.
Chris is just flabbergasted at this point.
Yeah.
So like the hat logo is part of the glove. But he's not wearing a hat.
So it's a...
This is the shittiest mascot ever.
Jesus Christ.
Right? I'm pretty sure the Hamburger Helper glove will beat the shit out of this guy.
Well, you at least give him the finger.
I have to look this up because I have not seen this glove before.
It would just be a slugfest, man.
All right, so it turns out we have one Arby's in the desert. And that shit is just way too far from me.
You have an Arby's in the desert and it's too far from you.
I'm not going to this crap. I've never been to Arby's.
I can't even tell me it's crap. You've never been there.
I didn't say it is crap. I'm just not going for this crap because it's shit. I'm not going to some shit that I don't want to go to. It's just too far. I will go to Arby's with you one day, Paul. You can take me to Arby's.
I'll take you to the meat.
You take me to the meat and you give me the whole Arby's experience. What the hell? I hear you can get like five sandwiches for $5 or some shit.
No, that was like 10, 15 years ago.
Okay.
What the hell is the thing you can get now where they'll just throw it all onto one fucking sandwich? Some ridiculous shit.
Oh. The Meat Mountain?
There you go. will seriously put, it's not technically on the menu, but everybody will make it. You can ask for the Meat Mountain. I think it's like $10, and they seriously will put everything on it.
They put chicken, ham, beef, turkey, like every version, every type of meat. I think it's like a hamburger patty.
Disgusting.
They put it on top of like two like Texas toast pieces of bread.
Yeah, this is what I'm
getting. Apparently it's like delicious.
This fucking thing is horrifying, man.
Yeah.
So it's not on the menu. Why does this sound like some sort of illicit shit that they won't hand to you at the counter? Like, you order it and some dude asks you to meet him out back.
Because if they put it on the menu, then they have to disclose how many calories it
is. No.
That's the worst.
Chris, put this up on stream right now. This thing looks delicious. I don't know about you guys.
Say, like, yo, my man. Got the meats?
Look at that shit.
Holy shit, dude.
It looks like he's got the meats right there. Look, he's got that glossy-ass looking side. His body is kind of folded inward.
That looks like the prequel to the meats, like, you know, Meats Redux.
There's even some chicken in there, too. Oh, my God. Oh,
before there was the meats, there was...
How come you've never taken me to Arby's before? You keep talking about Arby's, and you never told me about Meat Mountain.
Nobody else ever wants to go. I think I'm the only one.
I will go with you next time.
Jesus Christ, dude.
They got good barbecue sauce.
This is quite possibly the worst thing I've ever seen in my life.
You know what's good barbecue sauce? A Famous Dave's. I got like their spicy, like their hottest barbecue sauce. It wasn't really hot, but the flavor was amazing. Holy shit, that was good.
The fuck is Famous Dave's?
Barbecue joint. It's a chain. National chain or some shit.
Oh, like. I ain't going to Thousand Oaks. You fucked up.
Is seriously the closest Arby's to me in San Leandro? I'm not gonna go to San Leandro. Just
that looks so good.
Oh my god, dude!
How do you get the meats? Like, how did they come about?
The meat.
What did it become, did it come before or after this sandwich? I mean, like, I assume that at some point during Arby's history, there was a guy that walked into an Arby's and he literally said, "Give me everything on the menu."
Oh, of course.
And they came out with Meat Mountain.
Had to have happened.
Yeah.
95% sure it was some random trucker.
Hey, man, those guys don't have a lot of time to spare, you know?
Exactly.
You got to get their protein.
Look, I want all the sandwiches, but I want them in one sandwich. You only give me two pieces of bread.
You know what he said? He's like, I'm cutting back on carbs. Give me everything on two pieces.
Exactly. That's what this is. This is just a high protein thing right here. So you get very, very few carbs. Texas toast will have some carbs in it. There's going to be a lot of cholesterol in it because I'm pretty sure they, you know, they fry the Texas toast in butter. Not fry, but, you know, just put some butter on it.
Well, I wouldn't. It's Texas toast. I know. Everything's bigger in Texas.
Exactly.
When you guys keep talking, I might just go get a Meat Mountain, like, right now. Legitimately, just mute my mic.
You know, the rest of the stream will just be you trying to suffer through Meat Mountain.
Like, oh, like, God, I took some bites and I can't do
anything. You know what, Chris? What's this up? This is gonna be the new SDR commercial. Just me and you eating Meat Mountain.
That would actually be awesome. Just like it's like a time lapse halfway through. Chris is just like, oh, and Gibby's like, this is delicious. Keeps going.
What needs to happen is like Chris needs to have like a 1/3 of his Meat Mountain eaten, just like suffering, and then he's like leaning back in his chair, and Gibby's eating his, and then he just grabs Chris's and takes a bite out of his, and then he just keeps going.
Exactly.
I fall out the chair.
Just came up on an extra Meat Mountain.
Oh, god damn, dude.
More mountain for me, baby.
You know, the closest I've come to something like this was last year's SCR, where I got Vin to buy me two 4x4s. And, like, I didn't think he would do it.
He actually did it.
I remember that. That was hilarious.
He actually did it. And I was like, dude, are you serious? Like, I can barely eat one of these. He was like, you had me buy two of these? You're not even going to eat them, man? And I'm like, I can try. Well, no. I ended up like, pawning it off on Mike Z because he was starving.
Yeah, that's sweating. What it was. I'm like, I remember finishing someone's food. For those people who don't know, I'm not a big guy, but I can eat way more than Chris. I can eat a lot.
Yeah, he can. You know what's really sad about that story, actually? I gave it to Mike Z. Mike was extremely grateful because he had been bitching the whole day about how he hadn't eaten, right? So I was like, oh, here you go, bro. And then, like, 30 minutes later, he's like, yeah, I gave it to one of my staffers. He was hungrier than me. was like, what a
nicest guy in the fighting.
Yeah, man.
He sacrifices.
Not only does he sacrifice his food, he sacrifices code that his team comes up with just to give to other devs so they can work with PS3 sticks.
Sacrifices.
Maybe.
Man.
And time.
So
just to
much
keep...
money on this. But...
It's either that or Mike's like me and he's a really picky eater and he saw something you had on it and he's like, I'm not eating that shit.
Everything. Ugh.
As a resident fact checker, Mike is the finickiest of eaters.
Yeah, I knew it. I was like, fucking knew it. Like, I'm
peanut
pretty sure
jelly and frozen chicken
like
tenders.
He might get in the fights if there's any kind of garnish, like, you know, some cilantro on there.
Oh Jesus.
So you probably got it normal with everything on it and he took one look and he's like, sauce, somebody else eat this goddamn shit.
I'm a fucking casual man, shit.
Spread is terrible.
Yep. What did you just say?
Spread is terrible.
You wanna see me in the streets?
I'll see you in the streets, and you can see your spread on the fucking floor after I toss it out of your hand.
That sounds gross.
I slap out of his hand.
Why would you waste spread like that?
The spread
we're gonna see is your ass spread on the floor after I beat the shit out of you.
Only spread is gonna be on the centerfold of Dead Fucks Monthly. So.
God damn it! This was a prime opportunity for you to buzz out. The only spread that's gonna be is when the cops come out and tell you to spread them, because after you beat the shit out of me, you're going to jail. You should have just done that shit. You've been running this gig for like 2 years now, and you didn't use. You had a perfect opportunity. So disappointed. This is what having a job does to you guys.
You forget the fucking meat and potatoes of the argument.
You can have all the goddamn spread you want. That shit ain't never touching my burger.
This shit's delicious.
That's disgusting.
I'm sorry, man. If it's on a burger,
I'll
probably
eat it.
Pepperoncinos, buddy.
The perpetrators.
Yeah, exactly. I'm going to start ordering. Excuse me, may I have the perpetrator?
Can I have the peppermint mochiato?
The hell did you just say, boy?
Just order the new Perturbator album? What the hell?
Good album. Dangerous Days out now.
I'd like to.
You say you want that Pat Ledmore anime? What now?
Am I the only one that enjoys purposely mispronouncing awkwardly spelled animes just to piss people off?
No, I've been doing this forever.
Which one's not
awkwardly
spelled, man? Like, how many are not awkwardly spelled?
They're all awkwardly spelled. Like, they're anime.
Does anybody actually know how to pronounce Armitage? Whatever the fuck that shit is?
Hey, see? Like that. Like, you probably think that's legit. Like, Patalabord and Vagamia? What is all this stuff? This shit ain't English.
Robot.
I mean, that's not. It's anime.
Nah, yeah. Man. The best one is Robot Ek.
I used to do this to people.
Pronounced Robo Etch.
People get pissed off. I'm like, oh, Robot Ek. Yeah, that's a pretty good show. What is it? Robots. Is it about robots? And oh crap, people would get pissed off. Just pissing off. You know, pissing off anime fans in general is one of the greatest things.
It's actually drag on balls.
Oh my god.
Oh, is that the thing that stars that rapper Dragon?
The mm-hmm. rapper Dragon?
No, Dragon, man. Dragon. You guys remember Dragon? He was part of the Rough Riders.
No, I think that's the show that has Vegeta in it.
Oh, Velveeta?
Yeah, Velveeta.
Put that show on everything.
Velveeta? Pretty good? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Hey, everybody like that movie Acura?
Oh, you mean Acura and
Yeah, the car brand?
Yeah. That was a pretty good movie. Like, I remember, if I remember right, they have like a lot of drifts in that movie, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Reliable car.
Mm-hmm.
I know we had a show somewhere in here, but...
Look,
the
point is...
Arby's is fucking awesome. You awesome shader.
Take me to Meat Mountain right now.
Oh, my God.
Oh, God. I haven't been to Arby's in a while. I just like to talk about it. But
Meat Mountain.
Dude, launched.
Oh, are we actually a wrestling podcast?
Yeah. We actually have an explicit purpose. 9-9-9-10, which I don't know how much that is in American, but
873, something like that.
Okay.
That's pretty cheap.
If you can read Japanese. If you can read Japan.
If you read Japanese.
See, we're doing it already. We can't even stop now.
Forgot. Just pack it up. We're done here.
We're fucking done.
Little mama back.
I didn't even change the date of the ticker yet. So luckily,
God
people think this is last week's show. Luckily,
we don't even need a date.
Well,
you know what?
No. That's a good point. We do need to change our splash page. I think.
Yeah.
Can we just have the picture of Paul sick again? have a picture of that and the oven mitt from Arby's? I think that should just be a splash
picture. They're actually on the same frame, so I don't know if I can get them both up there.
It should be the Arby's mitt and you sick as an animated GIF, and then the Arby's mitt smacking the shit at you with Meat Mountain, and then you being healed.
Could we have,
that's advanced.
See, we need to, like, encompass all the things we, represent. As Capcom's premier fighting game podcast, could we have the Ryu from the X-Men vs. Street Fighter intro shaking hands with the Arby's oven mitt?
Wow.
Somebody wants to animate that, yes.
Clash of Titans right there. Yep, and then we can have John Cena come out and just go, like, the really angry, you can't see me shit, just walk away.
Oh, yeah.
That shit is so hilarious. If you guys have not seen the Reebok commercial, or is it Reebok? No, it's Foot Locker. The Foot Locker commercial with John Cena, go watch it. That shit is stupid.
This is already the best splash page ever.
Hey, Chris, I need to share something with you that legit upset me. You might want to add it.
Is this the John Cena geese?
Yeah, that's exactly it. I think it goes well with our ideas
here.
Yeah.
That one's so good.
Yeah, please put that up.
It's so terrible.
What?
No, yeah. It's great. It's amazing.
Oh, no! This is
the fucking rise of Bogart.
Why would you do this?
Why wouldn't you? I mean, really?
I mean, should I be scared? Not really, but I am.
I was impressed.
Yeah, I gotta say, it works really well. I gotta give it to him.
It may be one of the best drawings I've ever seen. And by drawings, I mean Photoshop.
No, what are you talking about? Shinkiro drew this shit knowing that John Cena would become amazing in the future.
Oh.
And he's like,
actually,
oh.
What if it turns out that Shinkiro drew John Cena because Shinkiro used to draw the most generic of human beings?
There you go.
He was just John Cena. He was drawing the entire time.
Yep.
Over and over again.
John Cena Kyo, John Cena Iori.
Jesus.
Oh, God, that's so good. I just can't stop looking at it. Oh, God, it's beautiful. So we actually do have a show. We have a few things to talk about. I promise. Maybe.
Something, right?
Yeah, X-Herd comes out this week.
Oh, yeah, totally. That's big news.
And this is the third installment of the Guilty Gear series, correct?
Third? You know what? I just realized what you just said. Fuck me for that.
Mm-hmm. So yes, this is we have plenty of, you know, gears. This one's coming out tomorrow, right?
I've heard nobody seems to know exactly when the game launches. Exactly. Some people have said that it's going to be available Tuesday in the U.S. on Japanese PSN, and some people are saying Wednesday still. I don't know.
Hmm.
Like, because some people have said, well, it translates to this, and it will be, and other people are like, no, that's wrong. But...
Oh, hold on. I got to stop. Chris, is this just scrolling the three pictures over and over? This is amazing. Shit.
Why don't we have sponsors yet?
I don't know. Why do... Oh, man.
All right, I'm gonna walk away from the microphone so I can collect myself. What were you saying, damn, Paul, about Guilty Gear?
But, so, for those who didn't know, 4Gamer has actually added both Elfelt and Sin to the wiki with pictures of all their normals and the whole rundown. And I was just taking a look at that now. I know you guys said you were looking at it earlier, and some of those normals look really cheap.
Yeah, Sin's. Sensor, they're really good. But
I can tell that off the bat because the way they were just like super fast and like really had good range, I'm like, great, I'm gonna be locked down from like three spaces away.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Another thing to note is I'm pretty sure Sin has been to Meat Mountain.
It's true.
Look at all the meat. He just pulls it out of his coat like, yo, meat.
No, maybe Sin is the one who has the meats.
Oh
maybe
my god, Arby's Sin.
It's not even Arby's.
He's just straight out the butcher shop, right? He's just like, give me what you got in the rack.
Pretty is he much. Like the Arby's to like Burger Sheriffs, like In-N-Out or McDonald's?
Is there actually any frame data on his normals, or are they just
just images? But there's likely going to be added.
Okay.
Because on the rest of the wiki, they all have at least some basic frame data.
Dude, his jump heavy slash looks ridiculous.
Like, yes, it
if
does.
That covers about as much space as I think it does. It's like,
I'm sure it does.
It's fucking Jin from Calamity Trigger. His jump B. Where he just jumps and does it, and you're just like, if you were in the air, you're dealing with it. Sorry.
His crouch heavy slash is stupid. That one is used in training mode, and it beats almost everything.
Is all that the smear frames?
You know? No idea.
It's all just one frame, and it all hits. It's just one giant hitbox.
I mean, I think that's what they're trying to go for.
If this was double X, it would be. I don't know how XR's going to work, but...
I mean, it could be.
No, it really could be.
He looks fun, though.
Yeah. And, of course, at the bottom of the page, there are beginner combos for him on a little YouTube video. I assume there is for Elfelt, too. I didn't look at
it. Yeah, there is. I was looking at him.
Elfelt apparently has a standing low to have in these games. What is it? Is it her stand kick or punch?
Yeah, stand kick. So I was going through her stuff. Looks like a standing low. It says under in that little top right green section there that all the screenshots have. So that usually says that's it's a low.
Okay.
And she also has a... She doesn't have an anti-air 6P. She has an overhead 6P.
That's
which
weird.
Might that's... screw her... Might screw her over in the anti-air department, but she apparently has...
Guns.
Well, she has guns, but she also has BB Hood's, you know, like, wine bottle flame as a normal.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's as a normal. That's her close slash.
Oh, weird.
So her anti-air game is probably going to involve running and doing close slash as they're jumping.
So her 6P isn't upper body involved?
None. It actually, from what I can gather from the... Japanese that I can understand for fighting game terminology and the horrible Google Translate, it explicitly says no upper body invul.
She'll be, I think, the only gear character without that then, ever.
Yeah.
Which is, that's bizarre.
Yeah.
But, you know, what's interesting about this, and I was talking to Steve when he came over for a bit earlier, is that we still haven't heard anything or seen anything about Leo.
I think we've seen a sprite.
Which we're not... Go for it.
I think all we've seen is just in-game models from story mode. I don't even think we've actually seen like a fighting stance from him.
Well, the in-game models are going to be the character models anyway.
Yeah, but he doesn't have his sword in the story mode stuff.
Wait, he's got a sword?
Two of them.
And, and his name is Leo? You mean this is the guy from Red Earth?
Yes.
is this Lion-O as well? Is he? Oh, what if he is Lion-O mixed with Leo from Red Earth? Oh, shit, that'd be sick.
You know it's a law that if your name is Leo or Lion, you have to have some sort of sword.
Right.
Yeah.
I knew that.
Yeah.
I mean, look at the Go Lion.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
I'm sure there's some exception to that rule. Like, there had to be a lion somewhere that just had breasts.
No, man. Muscles. California Statute 623B A2 says...
Well,
I mean,
who else? You know, like, we got, like, Shishio. He has swords. He throws them at you. There's a whole kinds of them.
What about VF Lion?
He's his fingers are swords.
Yeah, he's French.
Wow.
There you go. It's not Lion, it's Leon.
There you go.
Okay.
But, I don't know. I'm
and he's not
obviously, the they're also saving Leo for Guilty Gear Xrd asterisk Q.
Interesting.
That doesn't make sense.
No, it
mean?
Doesn't.
All the other ones are musical references.
And so is Asterisk Q. It's a Star Queen.
I don't know what that is.
Star Queen. It's obviously, you know, a hybrid of Ziggy Stardust and Queen.
And Queen. Okay. Yeah, okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you, dude.
Man, see, that's art.
That's,
so that's
not what I mean by musical reference.
That's a musical reference.
I'm waiting for XR Treble Clef myself.
There you go.
Treble Clef?
No, what I was going to say, though, is that because we haven't seen anything from this character... We're probably not going to see him until January at the earliest.
Right.
Which is interesting because all the other games, recently, we got DLC characters within the first week or two. Hmm. Even Margaret, who is probably the latest out of the three games, you know, obviously BlazBlue, Persona, and now Exord. Margaret came, what was it, a week or two most after the game was there? So, I wonder if they just decided that, or if there was a reason why he's going to be that late.
It's weird. A good example I think you can compare this to is when KOF 13 was announcing its DLC, which came way later after the console version came out, and they got each character in one by one, and I think by the game came out when? In September, I think, of 2010?
Came out November 2011.
2011. Really?
Yeah.
2011. Oh, that's right, because SCR was in 2011 that year. But at that point, we didn't even have, like, you know, EX Kill yet. I think we had, like, a prototype for him. And he was only playable at the SNK booth, or the Atlas mm-hmm. booth. And then we got EX Iori eventually. And, like, by the time, I think, like, Southtown started getting in full swing, we got Mr. Karate, like, a third of the way into the season. And that was at least, like, 5 months. And the worst part was we all knew they were coming, so, like, you know, the whole wait was horrible. It's just like, damn it, like, why is this even, you know, an option? Why is this an option for business? And the character ended up being terrible as far as design goes. So we wondered, like, what the hell were they doing with this guy for the whole time? So yeah. Hopefully, you know, they're actually spending their time, if they are going to bring Leo out later, that he's not going to be something that is just shoehorned into the game and totally fucks it up.
Yeah. Well, obviously, if he's on disc at all, he's only partially on disc. You know, there's just a template for him.
Right.
Because obviously, Sin and Elfelt are on disc. Sin might even just be part of the character select screen. I don't know how they're working that.
Yeah, I was going to ask, are they going to be free DLC or paid?
Elfelt is free the first week.
Right.
And that's sure what I've heard.
Everybody's just going to go ham on that because there's no reason.
Nobody's said anything about Sin even being considered DLC.
Okay.
He looks like
as far as I've seen. If he is considered DLC, I haven't seen them announce anything about him being free the first week or anything like that. So, I don't know how that's going to work.
I think if it's me, I'm just saying, you know, put him in for free because, like, it's a new console game. You got to give him something extra because otherwise we're just getting the arcade version with no actual change log.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, Sin isn't a DLC. I think he's probably going to be a beat the game story mode and you unlock him kind of stuff.
Yeah, so he's just like an old timey boss character thing.
Yeah.
Where you beat the game and now you can play this character.
Yeah.
Okay. That's cool. Like
Elf is the only legit DLC they've announced so far that we know when we're going to get because Lion, like you guys mentioned, is who the fuck knows.
Yeah. But of course, if that's true, then that means Elfelt, Leo, and one other person. Because every game has three. Every Arxis game has always had at least three DLC characters.
So that means there's a slot underneath Sin, which was brought up, I think, last week.
Yep.
There's a new spot that they hauled it out, so they're going to put somebody in there.
It looks that way.
Is there a random select slot?
I mean, I think there always was.
Actually, there's almost never been a random select
slot. Yeah, that's why I asked. Isn't random select like just going off the screen or some shit?
Yeah, it's if you are in between characters or off the screen, yeah.
Okay. So I'm trying to figure out if maybe it could be a random select slot. They're doing things differently this time.
That really would piss everybody off, I'm sure.
Someone showed me pictures. I forgot what it was. Pictures or an article saying that Anji and someone else. What's her face? Well, Sin's mom. Forgot her name. Go me.
Dizzy?
Oh, Dizzy. Oh, yeah. Johnny and Dizzy are in the...
Johnny. Yeah, they're in like the story mode or some crap.
I knew that Dizzy was in story mode, but I didn't know Johnny shows up.
She's still like frozen in time or some shit because they didn't free her in Overture.
But isn't that all still kind of somewhat different still? Yeah, they're still different because the Valentine that shows up in Overture is different from the two Valentines we've seen so far.
But they've claimed that they're related, I think. I don't know.
I don't know.
There was a thing.
Yeah, exactly. I don't know.
When they first started talking about Overture, they had a freaking timeline thing where it showed where Overture split off from XX and all that stuff, and so they had everybody believe that X and XS was an alternate storyline or even alternate universe, and Overture was a continuation of Missing Link, and then now this is like a marriage of the two, and then they retconned and said XX actually happened, and yeah, fuck it.
My brain just melted in that 5 seconds.
All you need to know is anime.
Got it. Got it.
It's Marvel, baby.
Oh, okay. That makes sense.
Yeah. No thanks.
So
like that, no thanks.
The game has crossplay. You could play your buddies on PS3 or PS4, no matter which system you have.
Which is awesome.
And you can also access the game through remote play, which is kind of sick. Chris, I'm going to show you this. I just find stuff like this, you know, pretty cool. Feel free to play that on stream. You guys can watch it too. This is pretty. This is pretty cool here for lazy people.
If I can get it up.
If you can, whatever.
But
that's interesting.
Taking a look at the little combo video for Sin, my ideas about how he would play seem right so far. Is that he looks like Hakumen, in that you can chain all of his special moves one after another. Now, whether he's going to play exactly like Hakumen, obviously not. But it seems that sort of Gatling special move ideal. Which might be really good for him. It's hard to tell at this stage, obviously.
Yeah. I'll give him a try if I get the game. Because Hakumen was the only character I really gave a shit about in Blaze.
Yeah. So, Alex, what do you think about Alphalt?
Just probably the character besides Slayer that I'm the most excited in messing around with. 6P being an overhead and not, you know, your traditional Guilty Gear anti-air is going to be interesting. And it actually helps out her play a lot, because most of her stuff, even in the example combo that they give you, they show that your idea is blah, 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 do damage, do, like, jump D, which is a air gun blast as an ender.
Mm-hmm.
And then cancel that into grenade pull. So the entire point is that whatever untech time that they have, you're going to cover them by pitching the grenade at them. And they have to deal with the explosion. And the explosion is going to mean a really simple three-way mix-up of overhead, standing low, crouching low, or even delayed throw. So she can do some really grimy stuff. And then if I can actually get someone that can read, you know,
Japanese
better than my I can only understand the fighting game terms. We can figure out what to do with, like, shotgun stance and its commando role and its apparent command throw that it has out of that stance.
Jesus.
Somebody said that there's partial frame data for the new characters listed online. One interesting thing to note that they pointed out, which I really hope is true, is that shotgun is or primed shotgun blast, where she takes the stance and then takes a secondary stance, that's one frame. So as long as you fire it, it's coming out.
Wow.
Yeah, that stuff's going to be kind of good.
That's pretty crazy.
So yeah. Is her air gun shot exactly the same as Cable's air gun shot?
It's hard to tell because they use it up close, and it has what's very obvious, a blast, like kind of hitbox. So, like, you see the blast coming out. It's very deliberate. The normal's listed there as the last jump normal.
Mm-hmm.
Like, a little heart comes above her head, and she fires her gun in front of her. So you can't really tell if it's firing a bullet that goes full screen, like her standing fierce or standing heavy, or if it's just the blast itself that's doing the hit.
Oh, okay.
It'll be really interesting if that is a full screen hit like Cable.
Yeah, because, I mean, it obviously seems like a lot of the ideas she has, she's obviously, you know, taken from part of Cable.
Yeah, she's got grenade. Some stuff.
Yeah, from grenade to her standing, I guess that's what, standing heavy slash, which is her gun?
Yeah, standing heavy slash is just Cable gun. Like, fire it multiple times, misses on crouchers.
So, it's going to be really interesting. But, and so, that of course comes out in a couple days, one or two days, depending on how it ends up shaking out. We get it in 2 weeks from tomorrow? Is that right?
Yeah, because the 11th?
Is it the 11th?
No, it's the 14th.
No, it's the 14th or 15th, yeah.
What the hell's on the 11th?
Oh, no, it's the 16th, because yeah, that's 16th. The Tuesday.
See, I thought it was 16th, too, but I was like, wait a minute, no, that feels like it's supposed to be something else, but I guess that's it. I'm waiting for that. I'm not going to get the Japanese download.
Yeah, that's probably better. So, Alex, you're interested in El Fuerte,
uh-huh.
I like to call her.
Yeah.
And you play Bullet, like, you just, like, only pick people that are, like, you know, gun references and things these days, or what's going on with that?
Did I ever give you my chart of how I pick characters?
Maybe.
Like, just look at what I play. Do they punch hard? Can they grip people?
She doesn't have either of that.
Do they set people on fire? I mean, do they have a gun?
Oh, okay.
Chris, put that image up.
It's See? Like, it's an easy chart.
So, I guess it's easy to say that...
Bullet Club. 4-4-1.
Oh my god.
Excellent. Well played. Well done, Tony. You're a raging idiot.
Yes, I am.
I might try to send out.
See, think about it, Tony. Cable is therefore the perfect character. He punches hard.
He does.
Has a gun. And is electricity fire? I like to say yes, so therefore he has everything.
He also beats the shit out of you.
Do grenades count as guns?
Oh, wait, no, the gun f***s you on fire.
Yeah.
I forgot.
Oh, yeah.
I always thought that was weird.
They're fucking incendiary rounds. What's weird about them? He's from the future. Shit needs to catch on fire.
Right? In the future, there aren't laws. Restrictions on incendiary.
They're all hollow points.
I don't believe the future he's from because everything I'm reading, we're going to run out of fresh water in like 40 years, so I'm pretty sure we're all going to be dead. That's how science works, right?
No, it's going to mutate.
Sure. Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah.
Yo, Chris, put that picture up. Put it in chat.
You put it in chat?
Yeah.
Yeah, so... Oh, no. So, if the game comes out next week or tomorrow, after tomorrow in Japan, we're going to have people here in the States playing. Oh, wow. It should be at NEC in some way, shape, or form. Aren't they doing like a Seoul-only tournament or some shit like that?
So it switched back and forth. Originally, Exord was going to be single limb singles, from what I had heard, because obviously they wanted to give the focus to Plus R still, because Exord will have come out on console in 2 or 3 days. But I think they're going to do teams single limb now. That was the last I heard. I'm not sure that that's 100% true at this point. So, Plus R is still the marquee game for NEC.
That's cool.
And then they're going to run Exord as well.
So have they secured some Exord setups? Because I know the Brett was asking about that a day ago.
Oh, how they're going to do it? I do not know. I assume they're just going to have people try to bring in their own systems. That's the only thing I can imagine.
Yeah, I imagine there's probably a bunch of dudes out there that are probably getting it on Tuesdays.
Yeah, I mean, so many people out here are probably getting it in the next 2 days, too.
Man. That's cool, though. It would be our first introduction to American Guilty Gear post-2014, I guess. I don't know. Yeah. I'm just looking for somebody to play Kai. And use a 3 Heart Slash. A lot.
But apparently, people in chat are saying that you can pre-download the game right now.
Oh, right. Kind of like pre-order download that unlocks, I think, a couple days later. Although
it's basically like Steam preloading the game.
Yeah. I mean, that's cool, because, you know, if you try to get it on Wednesday, it's probably going to suck, because... The servers are not going to be...
Yeah, the servers are
going to
get hammered.
Yeah, so get it while you can.
That's cool.
That is cool. We're almost there after, an entire year of waiting. It's coming out on console.
It's honestly weird to think.
Right?
You know what's... The game's almost here.
The weirdest thing about it for me is, this is probably the most promoted Guilty Gear I've ever seen in my life. I think BlazBlue has probably been promoted as much as this. I think, you know, Persona obviously was because it had the attack. Guilty Gear, for the most part, has always been a for the fans. If you like it, come get it. If you don't, then we'll see you in the funny papers, basically.
Yeah.
But now they're clearly trying to appeal to more people. They're doing this push that feels a lot like vanilla SF4, but a little more tasteful, I guess. You know, we're not getting, you know, they're not sponsoring UFC events.
Yeah, I don't know. I think for what they're doing, it's been pretty good PR for the game everywhere, including the US.
Right.
But obviously, there's still, you know, several steps behind companies like Capcom in catering to Western audiences.
Oh, totally, yeah. But it's weird, too, because, like, I feel like Guilty Gear is, like, such a westernized, or such a Western game. And
yeah.
Theme. I mean, if it wasn't for, like, the fact that everybody had the anime, you know, they were totally exaggerating the anime stigma, I think this is totally something that, you know, would be promoted in the pages of, you know, stuff like Dark Horse or something.
Yeah, I don't know. It could just simply be that because they are a very Japanese company that they'd never look to try to promote it in vehicles like that.
Yeah.
It's the only thing I can think of, at least.
Oh. It's still nice to see. It's great to see a game that basically started out as a high-profile doujin fighter, the first of its kind, and now it's like, you know, it's reached this status. I don't know any other game that's ever managed to do that.
I'm just excited because everybody seems excited about the game. So, but that always happens. We'll
yeah.
see. I think, you know, we'll reevaluate it in a month and see exactly where everybody is.
Just don't talk to Mike about it.
Oh?
Yeah. If you're watching Rebel Up on Saturday, he didn't say anything bad about it, but he's also saying, you know, he's probably going to... It's not his favorite idea, basically.
Well, I mean, Mike hasn't played... Obviously, since he's been working on Skullgirls, Mike hasn't been playing Guilty Gear itself that much. Anyway.
Oh, he has been playing it. He's been playing Plus R, but Mike always has very specific opinions about what he likes and doesn't like in fighting games.
So it's
and,
like his food?
Yes, because actually, since Skullgirls has become his job, it's become his job to play fighting games and play them in a manner to where he's just dissecting everything. So if he sees even a couple things that are done wrong, like, they could be even just visual things that just aren't to his taste, they're going to set him off. He's about as finicky about his fighting game as he is with his food.
Dude, that's like, he can't just sit down and play the game anymore. It's like, it's constantly analytical.
Yeah, he's gotten to that point. Like,
damn.
He knows what he enjoys, and he can also point out stuff he doesn't like. Like, one of the funniest things he ever pointed out to me that I'm sure most of us didn't notice because it's not something we pay attention to, is how the lighting is handled in Street Fighter IV. Ryu's, like, red fireball, right? It hits you, it comes out, the shit turns red.
Yeah.
It's an on-off. Is red fireball on the screen? First frame it's on, everything's red. First frame is gone, everything's back to normal. There's no transition to it.
Right.
Which, you know, in the real world, that's not how lighting works.
What? No way.
Yeah.
Look, you don't know this, right?
Look, I'm real world. The
real world could have, like, you know, pockets of a transdimensional world where it just stays red forever.
Hey, I was on the real world, Barrio Edition.
Oh, man. Hold on, wait. You were on that?
Yeah.
I was on that shit, too.
Oh, shit.
Were you the guy? Did you help me kick the shit out of that one white guy?
Yo, fuck white people.
Goddamn.
Is that when he went by the name of Manuel Chest?
Yeah,
Cut down. But I mean, I understand that to a certain extent. I can. It's hard for me to read anything now, and if I notice,
good man,
a typographical error, it just destroys me.
Right. That's something that, like, I think, you know, once we all get into a point where we pursue what we love, and then we start becoming, you know, just critical of it, and we become good critics of it too. And then sometimes people just stop enjoying shit. So I hope Mike hasn't gotten to that point where he just can't enjoy anything anymore. And he's just like, oh, man, I really... Like he said he's not a huge fan of Blaze Blue. But he said, like, oh, man, I love Arakune's fucking design. You know, it's a great design. Art and everything. Bye.
Yeah. Well, you can pick things about it that you like, even if while you pick it apart is the problem.
Yeah.
So you end up getting to a point where you can't enjoy the overall product even as you enjoy people. It kind of sucks, but that's what happens when you're that driven in a certain field or when you get entrenched in a certain line of work over a long enough period of time. Because you feel like you've seen everything before.
Right. And that's why I feel like it's weird where people who are, like, not even in that profession or even not even like they, not like they even have the analytical eye, they just can't they seem to be the most critical, I feel. I mean, I'm not apologizing for bad game design or anything, but I feel like a lot of people are just like, this game, I can't explain why I don't like it, but I'm going to bash it anyway.
I personally think bad game design is one of the best things to happen, because a lot of bad game design Like, they'll have some mechanic in there that's amazing, that gets used in something else. That's essentially what fighting games are. A lot of the bad mechanics from old fighting games were refined and turned into something good in newer fighting games.
Yeah, that's
it's
true.
It's just like it's evolution, the evolution of the fighting game. Mm-hmm. And one of the things I really love about Mike Z, he appreciates all these old shitty games. Whether they're old and good, old and bad, he loves the terrible mechanics in a lot of these old games. And he, you see in Skullgirls, a lot of these mechanics are in there. It's different. And they're better in Skullgirls than they are in, say, other games. And I like that.
Oh, I'm not saying that, like, you know, you can't see it. Like, there was a good, like, I've recently rediscovered Asura Blade, right? And it's not something I would say that I would have been super excited about maybe 5 years ago, but looking at it now, I'm like, oh, man, I've played so many games that, you know, this stuff looks pretty, had some pretty cool ideas back then. I mean, yeah, I won't lie, that game is clearly, you know, it's on the bottom
of
the pile.
But. It's like watching Arturo has been streaming SVC Chaos the last few days.
Yes.
And being able to sit back and look at that game, because honestly, I barely played any of that game, because as I was getting really into fighting games, I was into Guilty Gear, and it came out, and everybody's like, that game's fucking garbage. So I didn't really bother with it. But watching people play it and finding out all the different things about it, you start to see the evolutionary dead ends that the game came up with, or what evolved into later games, like in the KOF series. But you also understand why the game just fucking didn't work. Like, what they were doing. So it's always interesting to have hindsight when you look at games like that.
I mean, the point is, though, you have to be paying attention. I think a lot of people don't, and they just see a new game, and they try it out, and they're like, wait a minute, this feels familiar, you know?
Well, not only that, a lot of people will try, like, SVC Chaos. It's a bad game. Okay, simple as that. It's a bad game. There are, like, little bits of it that are like, oh, wow, that's a pretty sick mechanic, that's a neat mechanic. But all people will focus on is the bad game. And a lot of people have never played the game. They've never even watched the game. They just heard, oh, you know, SNK versus Capcom Chaos. The game is
exactly.
Shit.
Exactly. It's bad. They've heard it's bad.
It's like, oh, did you play it? No. Well,
and you know what? There's no excuse for them not to play it, because every year at Evo, there's a cab for it. At freaking, what's it, Excalibur. So you can walk your ass over to Excalibur and play it. It's stick and button, but it's there. And you can figure out for yourself why it's bad.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of the game, but it's for other reasons. The game itself, it's fun to play. Okay, simple as that. It's dumb and it's fun. It's one of those games. At high level competitive play, don't play it. But if you're just messing around with your friends, play it. Watching Arturo stream it again just reminds me. Like, he picks Zero, the best character in the game. Okay, and all he tries to do is the infinite. He's like, oh, did I just hit you in the air? All right, let's just see if I could tiger. Yep. Oh, wow, look at this. I'm just trying to get you with these infinites. He keeps dropping them. But it's relatively easy to do once you get the timing down. And yeah,
what am I looking at? Holy, I'm sorry.
What?
The Flintstones and WWE Stone Age SmackDown trailer?
Are you watching Raw? Why would you do that?
No, I'm not. This it was linked to you, Paul. Nope. John Cena Stone.
I got it from you, Paul.
I mean,
Daniel Bryrock? Oh my god.
You know what? Maybe you should stop looking at my timeline.
Guys. the stench of anime just walked in. What is this?
There's a stench of anime?
Yeah.
Oh, you totally called her out, and now she's backing out.
Yeah. I just smell anime.
Slowly creeping away from the
weed just came in. I don't know what it is.
Hey, Kelly.
What?
Alright, so I need your expertise. You can read Japanese.
Yeah.
Okay, so,
I like that.
What the fuck does the word trombone mean?
What?
This has been haunting me. Like, it's haunting me for the past month.
It's been haunting me, too, because after you said it, I was like, okay, well, I need to look further into this. What could trombone possibly mean but trombone? And all I'm coming up with is trombone.
Okay, so let's try to, like, parse this, just through shitty Google translating. So it keeps coming up on this Guilty Gear wiki, and it keeps coming up more and more when I read Japanese to English translated pages for fighting games. So here you go, Chris, if you want to read along with me.
Okay.
This page for Zato, the word comes up a lot for him. So go to his air throw, and it says, the English translation, enters into the opponent's body, throwing air damage. Obviously, that's what the animation is. It does an air throw. Since the technique after opponent is down, the opponent is knocked down,
it then says, and try to expand the place trombone by summoning the Eddie. Like, okay, it's telling you, it's obviously do something on their wake up. Get Oki, but what the fuck does trombone mean? It keeps coming up.
Tell me where this is on the page.
Go control F. Actually, if you want to just look it up in the original Japanese, go to what are jumping normals or air normals.
Okay.
It's the last one in the bottom of the command moves.
Jump. Got it.
Yeah, it says sky.
Jump nage.
Yeah.
Or kuchu nage.
Okay, wait, which jump is it?
It would be... No, not the jumping normals. It's actually below that one. So at the bottom of the next section, it should say kuchu nage.
Uh-huh.
And then...
Unsolved Mysteries, Guilty Gear Edition.
It says something trombone.
It's not in kana, right?
I think it probably just means that, using...
No, I'm not, saying whatever. Trombone.
What the fuck does it keep translating it to trombone?
Hold on. I'm on the case, though. So.
Like, Alex, every instance I see it in, it's referring to placing Eddie somewhere.
Yeah.
It's using Eddie in some way, shape, or form. It's probably saying what his, like... I never knew what these things were called. Me and Nock, we'd always call them stands, because that's from JoJo's, like, oh, it's a stand. Like,
familiar.
Yeah, Eddie's a stand user, pretty much. Yeah, familiar stand. It could just mean that. But
Hold on. I'm doing the most amazing, like... Here, okay, try to expand the place trombone. I see it. Okay. I literally have the Japanese and the English up next to each other right now. So we're going deep. Okay.
All right, and this just in, thanks to the Superdozer. Apparently, people are already downloading gear.
They're preloading it.
Preloading
it,
yeah. So... Oh.
He's a real tromboner.
Thank like, you. At the very first paragraph for Zato, the translations here says, for example, even taking place trombone 1, attack of Zato does not end at once. So it's like, all right, he's saying something about simultaneous attacks with little Eddie, but why the fuck does it perpetually mention trombone?
Is it about pressure, maybe? Like applying pressure?
Yeah, it's probably pressure or traps. One or the other.
If it's pressure, that'd be the best. Just like start translating that in English, like, yo, trombone this dude down. Like,
give him the trombone!
The way you're putting it in context makes it seem like it's talking about, like, on their wake up, you can pressure them.
Place trombone.
Place trombone firmly in
enemy. This is my project.
Yeah, there's this, and try to expand the place trombone by summoning the Eddie. I'm pretty sure it just means trap, lockdown, pressure.
This sounds incredibly gross, by the way.
It means set play. It means set play.
Oh, okay. So trombone is a new set play. It makes
sense. There you go. Well, everybody replace set play with trombone.
Yeah, I'd much rather hear trombone than set play.
This sounds incredibly gross.
new memes.
Yeah.
We've done it.
Oh my god, I feel so strongly about this though, because this is bothering like the I should know why this is saying this part of my brain. Like I didn't fucking waste my life in school to be fucked up by trombone. Come on.
Look, we know you didn't go to school. You learned Japanese on the streets of anime and shit. So
the streets of anime. The streets of old VHS tapes. Mm-hmm.
There's just a compound verb in here, and like part of the compound verb, it's translating as trombone for some fucking reason, even though it can also mean the dominant of a homosexual relationship.
Okay.
I do it!
Well.
They're sneaking in the dirty talk and guilty gear.
With Google Translate.
They're sneaking in that dirty talk. They're just basically saying, just give them the trombone, you win.
Give him the trombone.
Firmly insert trombone into enemy.
That's a slang term. The actual term means attack.
Yeah, basically.
Say, up or something. They're basically saying, like, yeah, to rise up.
Some fucking Fujoshi shit, man.
Yo.
So to rise up is, like, on their wake up?
Their trombone rise above rises hate. Up.
See? Rise above hate, John Cena?
Oh, every time. I'm not going to do it.
I don't, you know.
What a mystery.
Yeah.
It's literally semi. Y'all know what that fucking
word
is.
Yeah, I know what it means.
No,
horrible.
I don't.
Semi.
Okay, well,
I do.
Semi, Seme is literally like in like yaoi fucking manga. It's the dude who sticks his dick into the other dude's booty.
I told you! I knew it!
They're literally translating Seme as trombone for some reason in Google Translate.
Go back to the original definition of set play? Because it apparently shows up a billion times on Millia's page.
See, they are marketing to Western audiences.
So, the trombone basically means... the trombone.
I told you, the tromboner.
There are semes and there are ukes.
That's all right. We don't need to go down that hole.
This is a rabbit hole I'm not willing to dive down.
It's not uke, okay? It's called a ukulele, not a ukulele.
Excellent.
Wow.
The trombone and the ukulele. Okay, I don't
know. See? Yeah, there you go.
Tiptoe through the tulips. Got it.
Eddie, you dog. Where's that sousaphone sound effect where it's like...
This just in. Apparently there's Sailor Moon toilet paper. For those who are curious, I'll retweet it. Retweeted.
That's actually perfect.
And there's the back of it. Sweet Jeeves.
I feel like we've gone down a dangerous path.
No, we figured out what trombone means. Like, it's obviously it's whoever has the dominant position on wake up.
I thought it translated to behind.
The person who's doing the pitching.
You know, that was I would have to say that was a great synthesis, Alex. Well done.
We did it.
It means attack, you fuckers. It's a slang term. It's attack and defense. God damn, I hate you all.
See, you're just mad because you're
going to be getting the trombone starting January.
You want to be the trombone, but you're just a ukulele. That's what you're
fuck that. I'm all about the trumpet.
Well, where does that fit in?
Oh, my God.
The French horn, a.k.a. Kai.
Oh, wow. Really, we're going there?
So, the French horn is basically a buster.
So, what you're saying is Mambo number 5, you and the trumpet.
The French horn
is Mambo number
most...
5, Lou Bega or Mike Ross? Which one?
Yeah.
Can we go 1 week without mentioning Lou Bega? Like, please.
Never gonna happen. Never gonna happen. Look, two things I need to get into.
I came in here and I got, like, really gay.
Two things in every podcast, WWF and Lou Bega.
Today's WWF talk was Flintstones meets the WWF, which I watched that trailer. That's pretty good. I like it.
Tony's killing himself right now.
Hey, Tony, if you think about the Flintstones, you know, versus the WWE, you think the Rock's just on there, but they don't change anything about him? He's just Rock? Like,
the Rock.
Like, none of his...
The real question is, when are we going to get, like, New Japan Pro Wrestling versus, like, Doraemon at this point?
Doraemon.
Stand by me, Dora.
Doraemon. What the hell is a Doraemon?
Or have, like, other classics, like Cyborg 009 meets, you know...
Doraemon.
Considering that New Japan has had several wrestlers who are based on anime already, I think we're kind of there.
Yeah, I mean, Tiger Mask already technically exists, and his had a whole bunch of real wrestlers in it, just from even the first chapter.
Well, and Jushin Liger is based on an anime.
Yeah, so. I mean,
they're already anime as it gets.
But the real question is, when are we going to get old, dead Hanna-Barbera wrestling with Japanese wrestlers?
Why would we want that?
Are we going to get Magilla Gorilla?
Magilla Gorilla?
To beat the shit. No, will we get Grape Ape versus the Big Show?
No, I hated that game.
Shit.
So, okay, here's what we're going to do. Instead of Corporate Kane, which is really boring, we're going to have him dress up all in purple, and we're going to call him the Big Grape Machine. It's genius.
I still like my idea. Work with these people. I still like the idea of the Big Bread Machine where he just makes bread like he's a baker.
I mean, that would be delicious, but I just don't think it would get over.
It can't be any less over than it already is, man.
Oh, man.
Oh, he's over, but I mean, not in the slang term.
His career is over.
Yeah. It's over.
Oh, he's over, all right.
Shout outs to Randy Orton. He loves hot dogs on the job.
What?
Whoa, is he chilling with Mark Sanchez?
Yeah, you're thinking of Mark Sanchez.
No, you've never seen that video on Boxing Radio where they fucking caught Randy Orton eating one of the hot dogs that when fucking Dean Ambrose ran out with that hot dog stand and attacked him and Seth Rollins. And like he fucking just dumped him. And like the camera pans and you see fucking Randy Orton just fucking snarfing a hot dog.
No, I don't, dude. I don't know much about Randy Orton, but I respect the shit out of the guy now. It's like, I'm on the job, might as well eat. You know, I need these calories for this
fight. He's like, I'm so hungry. Fuck it.
He needs to chill with Mark Sanchez, and so he can advise him about the chicken tenders and whether they're good or not.
They're good.
Good. Yeah, we already know that.
Here's your giant chicken tender. They're good.
Hey, see, special guest Mark Sanchez. What other fighting podcast will bring NFL stars on the show?
Well, let's not get too crazy. I wouldn't say star.
He is a
Have you not seen the Sanchez go nuts these last couple weeks?
Look, man, when he first came into the NFL, he carried his team to the playoff. He could have carried them to a Super Bowl victory, but the chicken tenders at the time.
Look, Chris, yeah. You keep talking shit, you're going to get your ass Sanchez.
Oh, all right.
I thought...
I'm going to spread out on the floor after you whoop my ass.
He's going to whoop your ass and then run into it and fumble the ball.
Can't be any worse than Oakland. Oh, man.
What the fuck were we even talking about?
I don't know.
Trombones.
We had Guilty Gear Xrd and it turned into trombone, and now we're talking about how Oakland apparently tackles itself on punt returns.
No, what we're talking about is how this weekend, one of the biggest events is going to happen. It's going to have like personalities there. What is it called? Shit. What's the name of the event this weekend?
Southern Cross.
Oh no.
Conferences.
Oh no. Forgot. Oh, it's the Raiders versus Niners. That's what it is. Forgot. Yeah. So yeah, the Raiders versus Niners is going on this weekend. There's this smaller event called NEC going on, but you know, no one really cares about that because the Raiders are playing the Niners. And every article I've read is like, it's going to be a bloodbath. It's like, really?
Oh.
It might be because it might rain.
I mean, look, check it out. Here's two things. So the Niners lost this past week, right?
Yep.
Yeah. And then the Raiders, they didn't lose. They didn't lose. They got manhandled, destroyed, wrecked. I don't know. There's so many different...
By the only team in the NFL that has a better record in like the last 10 years than them.
And
can we talk about how much shade got thrown on my flight back from Boston to L.A.? Like, I get on and sit down, and he's like, who's excited to go back to L.A.? I'm guessing it's none of you because they don't have a real football team.
See, if I was on that plane, I would have just yelled at the guy. We have a football team.
They just
right?
suck.
They just happen to live in Oakland for
They're
now.
They're just all
right?
wearing bags on their heads right now.
The Los Angeles Raiders of Oakland.
Exactly. Thank you. Right,
so the Raiders are going to college in Oakland. They'll be back in a few years.
Wait, Boston's talking shit about a football team when they like claim like three?
Yeah, well, I'm not none saying of them are that I understood Boston. What was happening.
You should have
said it was happening in front of me.
You should have told that guy, like, hey, man, how about, you know, Tom Brady's little potty mouth?
Potty mouth.
You didn't see that shit? That was the best.
Oh, yeah, where he, at the very end, he's like, fuck, fuck, fuck. He's like screaming hello.
Okay, Aaron Rodgers gets the first down, he's like, fuck, fuck. And just 5 minutes ago, he's high-fiving everybody, saying, hey, guys, I'm back. Everybody loves me. Not really.
Yeah. Good old Tim Brady.
Yeah. So, what do you guys think is going to go down this weekend? I was supposed to go to this here Niner game, but
But you're ducking.
I'm ducking because I had to spend a shit ton of money on a new phone because mine got stolen.
That's
and me being the generous Raider fan that I am, I gave my ticket to a terrible, horrible Niner fan.
Oh, good! Hell yeah, dude!
He's going to go and place me. The stipulation we have is that he's going to root for the Raiders, right? Yeah.
Dude, Walker, you are... Tony.
That's going to happen.
Tony, you're totally going to get a chance to sue somebody this weekend.
Oh, you're right!
Yeah, man.
I better go in full gear,
you're
then.
You're going to be a fucking millionaire, man.
All I'm going to say is if by some aligning of the planets, the Niners manage to lose to the Raiders this weekend, I hope Colin Kaepernick is forced to retire as the worst quarterback ever.
Like, no way. No way he will retire.
This has a really good game because the Niners play like complete shit against the worst teams. And the Raiders play fairly well against the best teams.
Niners throw perfect passes to the defensive team.
Right? Well, I mean, Kaepernick wants to throw to the open man.
He did.
And he threw it to the open man, right to his chest.
Like, oh, Kaepernick's going to the outside. Everybody duck!
It's, like, seriously, this has the potential to be a really good game. I wish I was going to go. I mean, I wish I was able to be there. I want to be there, but I can't. And it's going to be good. Chris. Yeah.
What's up?
It's going to be good. The major fighting game personalities that are going to be there are going to be Hell Pockets, Random Llama, and Lord Walker. Okay, think about that. I mean, why would you go to NEC when you can go?
That's great. True. I think that's going to be more entertaining than NEC, especially, you know, considering it'll be me and Tony running for our lives.
I'm just going to say, if the Raiders win, I mean, we're going to say goodbye to the Bay Area. But at the same time, I hope...
Did we lose Chris?
Yeah.
Well, yeah. It's Comcast.
So, yeah, stream
yes.
Drop.
Oh, yeah.
So, check it out. Here's something that I noticed, too. This is, so the Raiders and Niners have played 12 games, like, ever, together. They've played 12 games, and it's 6-6.
Wow.
Yeah, right? Now, look at this. When the Raiders, like, the Raiders did the best as the LA Raiders. Like, they destroyed the Niners. So we'll see. Look at this shit. So, okay, LA Raiders, 1-2-3. Yeah, LA Raiders destroyed the San Francisco Niners. Yeah. No, I'm going back even further to the 70s.
Yo, are you trying to
I think it might be back up. I don't know. They're listening to us argue about this shit. Okay, go, Paul, continue your shit. Yeah.
They can hear us?
The stream's not back yet. Hold on.
I don't know if they can hear us.
The stream's not back. Maybe. Whoa. I know. Whoa. You know, I've been taking pictures of this. Are we back? Yeah, we're back. Good. Yeah, so sorry everyone. Hell Pockets had a connection issue. He is the host of the stream. Comcast sucks. Hell Pockets didn't have a connection issue. Comcast is just gutter trash.
Yeah, it's ugly.
Yeah.
As you were explaining the tech and event.
Yeah. Oh, okay. So this weekend...
Turn off the NFL music, goddamn.
Yeah, exactly.
Do you want to get sued, goddamn it?
Yeah, that's why I was like, we can't do that.
Yeah, I was about to say, whole show just got muted. Well, that happens. But this weekend, the Tekken 7 event called Thanksgiving, they're going to have an exhibition tournament of what there's a bunch of players, like world champion caliber players with special guests. And they're going to talk about the newest developments with Tekken 7. And I think Tekken 7 is supposed to be out next month or the following month. I can never remember. But it should be a really good place to see what the game is looking like now. Obviously, the Loke tests weren't the most updated version of the game because they've done some work. But I don't know. It's going to be really interesting to see what Tekken 7 is up to look like.
You know, is it bad that I'm more interested in seeing the tweets to Harada than the actual game? Because when the game comes out, or when like information from this test come out, and fans are going to be like, what, they did this? Harada, and Harada's going to retweet this and then tell these people they're dipshits. I want to see that.
Oh, the full Kamiya treatment?
Yes, yes. Yeah. Kamiya and Harada, they're the two best. They're the greatest.
God, I want to be him.
They're the greatest.
One time a friend of mine tweeted at Kamiya, because Kamiya came onto Twitter. He was like, good morning. So my friend's like, good morning, Kamiya-san. Are there any games you're looking forward to? And he just tweets back at my friend, no.
Nice.
Did he also block your friend?
It's just blocked.
Kamiya just responds, games are shit. Blocked.
Yeah,
that dude
just doesn't give a fuck.
I think Tekken 7 is... I think it's going to be a nice change of pace.
I hope it is. I'm currently afraid that for all the systems that they were trying to replace or remove from Tag 2 and 6, they're adding just as many new little tweaks to the gameplay that people are not going to
no new players are going to join. That's the biggest fear I have for the game.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think just in general, 3D fighters, Tekken, Virtual Fighter, Soul Calibur, don't pull in new players.
Yeah, I was about to ask, as someone who doesn't really know that much about 3D fighters, like, how many new people did Tag 2 pull in?
Tag 2, I can't imagine it pulled in many at all.
Yeah. Like, well, one of the issues is, and KOF had the same problem, and I think Gear is going to have the same problem as well. The vets are really good. Okay. They're leaps and bounds better than people coming in fresh to the game. They try to teach people the game, and all three games I've seen, they try to teach people the game, but people are either unwilling to learn or they want to learn. They just hate losing. You have the few who stick with it. Like, saying King of Fighters example, you have Wild Wallace. He stuck with it. He stuck with it. And he's like, he's rare as shit. He's like a diamond in the rough. It's like, oh shit, he was getting all this kid does, and I feel bad for him. He got his ass beat by like all the big names. Some vets, some weren't vets, but he's still stuck with it. I want to see people do that with Gear. I want to see people do that with Tekken. And not one or two people. I want to see a shit ton of people do it, because I hate to say this, with Gear, I really do think it's gonna be like a month or two of people playing, going nuts at most, a month or two of just people like, yeah, this game is shit, and then dead. Like, not dead, yeah, not dead, but it's just gonna be the Gear scene playing it again. That's it. It's like the same people who were like playing like Slash in a broom closet at Evo.
Hey, how do you expect the game to survive when Omega Mode's coming out?
One thing I think that Gear and Tekken 7 have for them right now is that they've sort of tried to go that SF4 route where there is big damaging super moves that can make people feel rewarded.
Yeah.
Obviously, Tekken 7 Rage Mode is now at least in the last build, Rage Mode was basically replaced by supers.
Yeah, and that shit was amazing. I got
which
say.
Did a shit ton. Yeah. God damn. And obviously, Gear has Hellfire, which is similar to something like. Kinda? It's basically, once you're under a certain amount of life, your supers do egregious amounts of damage. So, I think are going to be a little frustrating for experienced players at first, and maybe will allow some new players to get wins they might not otherwise deserve, but that, because the experienced players. About the new system.
I think that's a skewed perspective. Yeah. Like, deserved? I mean, if it's new for both of us, we can learn it at the same pace.
Yeah.
The only wins I get are the ones I don't deserve.
I don't... look.
Right?
No. The way I see it, if you won, no matter what, you deserve the win. Unless you elbowed the shit out of the person in game.
Or
if
you ripped
winning,
like a really
bad
fart.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
No. Well, even if ripping a fart is fine. Like, the way I see it, if you win, if things happen in game and you happen to win by some fluke chance, you still deserve the win because
you
won.
Well, then wins they would not have otherwise gotten. How about that? That's way longer to say.
Yeah, that could work.
But I think if those help people get into the game, I'm all for it.
Yeah, because like. Yeah, like, look at Street Fighter 4, for example. When Ultras were introduced, oh my god. Like, I would have won that match, but he Ultra'd. If Ultra wasn't in this game, I'd have won. You don't really hear that shit anymore.
No.
Because it's become part of the game. Simple as that.
The hilarious thing, though, is when you hear people bitch about losing to Wake Up Ultra still.
Oh,
this
yeah.
Late
yeah.
Into the game. I just laugh about that. Yeah.
No, man, it was a Wake Up Ultra.
Whenever someone Wake Up Ultras, I just have to go like lay down in a dark room for a while, just sort of let it wear off.
I guess someone dropped. They're saying they only hear me. The hell?
What?
Yeah.
Does that even work?
I don't know.
I think they only want to hear you. That's the biggest.
Oh, they only want to hear me. Hey, everyone. How's it going? Hold on. Let me. Okay, test. Okay, I hear Kelly. I hear me.
I hear all of us. That's what's really weird.
I can hear you.
Yeah, if they can't hear Hell Pockets.
How is the show even here? I'm so lost.
How are we even here?
Anthony, kill that shit. Kill that shit.
Seriously, can't hear.
Yeah, it's just me. It's just me. What the hell?
What? Everybody else?
It's only me and Kelly that people can hear. Okay, now they're saying they can hear Paul. Here, let's rehost
this. Gibby, you're also recognizing that there's a chat delay, right?
You're stupid. I'm listening to the actual podcast.
No, you're not.
Okay, I'm going to kill the call. Anthony hosts. Alex is a dumbass.
Okay. Welcome back.
See, this fixes it. Yeah, hopefully
Can we just do a quick test if you can hear everyone then? Gibby, yep. Say something.
Test. Balls. Test.
There we go. Test balls. Paul, say something.
$9.99.
Oh, goddamn it.
Tony, okay, say something.
Hello.
There's me.
Kelly. Well, Kelly's dead.
There's no Chris.
Chris hasn't said anything.
Oh, Chris, say something.
Okay.
Oh, wow. All right.
Okay, so far here, everyone.
Let me try this. I'm pretty sure you can hear me, right? Yeah?
Yeah.
I live in the American Gardens building on West 81st Street.
Oh, okay. Okay. I guess we're back, other than I guess Kelly fell into a hole.
No, there's no Chris.
Wait, there's still no pockets?
Chris, did you mute yourself through XSplit?
What the hell did that happen?
You are a complete idiot.
This is what anytime I hear people complaining in chat, I turn up the volume to...
The volume?
The stream. No, the stream. Like, I have the stream muted. I turn it all the way up when someone complains about not hearing us, and I mute everyone else, and I listen to this shit that's going on. Chris, I can't hear you.
Is there, like, a hotkey to do that?
There you go. Now I can hear you.
Is there a hotkey for that?
Probably.
I don't know what it is.
You know, I was actually going to commend you at the end of the show for not fucking...
...day. But you fucked up the rest of the
show. You fucked up the intro.
Like... It's been muted the whole time.
Jesus, man.
Okay, yeah, so, this is a rare episode of Super Desperation Radio where I have died and the others are just talking to
Garfield
my ghost.
Garfield without Garfield, except it's Hell Pockets without Hell Pockets.
Exactly, right?
So,
And we lost Kelly.
Ooh. Yeah, no.
So...
She probably fell back in.
Can we talk about NEC without, you know, like, being distracted by Meat or John Cena?
Go for it.
No. Not gonna happen. Meat Mountain exists.
Yep. Sweet Jesus.
I'm gonna go get one after the show.
I think the most interesting part is UNEL having a shit ton of entries.
Definitely.
Mm-hmm.
Is it free entry by anyone?
No, UNEL is not free.
Okay, because I guess there's another anime game that's free entry. Like KOF and some other anime game are free entry and they have like crazy numbers.
Well, the official numbers, or official numbers as of earlier today, I think.
Mm-hmm.
UNEL at 117, which puts it, I think, after Marvel in terms of entrance.
Because last I checked, Marvel had less than Undernight.
Whoa, Undernight might have surpassed it.
Yeah.
P4U at 86, Gear at 66, Blaze at 60. DFC signups not listed. They're going to be at the door.
Out the door.
And, wow. Mm. But that's really interesting. Like, I'm glad people are this excited to play UNEL.
Yes.
What?
I don't see anyone playing it anymore, to be honest with you.
You don't see people talking about it. People are playing it. I'm glad you said that, because this is something that's been bugging me. When people say, like, oh, game's dead, it's like, no, it's just everyone's playing it. They're not talking about it.
Like, I don't see streams for it anymore. I don't see much at tournaments anymore.
There's streams. Hanzo's streaming right now.
Yeah, I was about to say, this is why I bring it up, because Carter's streaming it right now. Like, holy crap.
Gibby, the thing is that everybody stopped talking about it, and they're being about it.
Yeah.
Like, see, I can't believe this.
It's been a while. Yeah. It's been a long time since anybody's actually played the game and not bitched about it.
Seriously, I don't see anyone playing it. I don't hear anyone talking about playing it. They talk about how it's a great game, whatever, but no one is
actually people are just playing it, and if they stream, they probably stream so much that it's like, hey, the people that want to watch already know. There's fucking, you know, different regions across the U.S. that are playing it. There's events going on in Japan for it. You know, people are just enjoying a game. Like, it doesn't have to constantly have noise like fucking Street Fighter 4 with, you know, Ono announcing an announcement about an announcement at an event that's not going to happen that maybe got canceled, switched to another place in a different country.
I don't expect that with this.
Like, is that what we want? Is that what we need? Like, I don't think we have these games.
We don't have the capacity to keep that up.
Like, I don't even want this to fucking be kept up. I don't want this constant noise. Like, I'm going to go fucking play this Third Strike at the arcade. Let me fucking tweet about it. Promote this shit on my Instagram. Check out my SoundCloud mixtape, fam. I'm going to hit you with all the fucking bars. Third Strike, y'all, is Street Fighter 3. I'm not going to do that on the fucking Twitter every night.
So you're making a Third Strike mixtape, huh?
You forgot about the follow-up tweet. Like, man, there's some cheap-ass motherfuckers in this arcade house tonight, man. I'm leaving.
Yeah. Like, they say... these dudes say they can beat Chun. Where they at, though? Like, we don't need this shit. Sometimes people just want to go out and play without fucking doing the entire, like, you know, whole nine yards for this shit.
I can't wait to hear Alex spit bars over Jazzy NYC.
There's actually a rapper that did it. I found it like a couple months ago and I forgot the guy's name, but it's pretty tight.
But yeah, I definitely agree. I also think that there is way more noise about games on the East Coast than the West Coast right now. So if you don't follow a lot of those guys, because honestly, West Coast is really scattered right now in terms of Air Dashers. Like, not much happens on Thursdays anymore. They do Rebel Up every 2 weeks, so they don't really need... That's already a set in stone thing. They don't really need to talk about it too much.
There's no NorCal regular stream anymore.
Actions speak louder than streams.
I don't think Pacific Northwest is even putting anything up lately.
They usually never do, but they always play.
Yeah, they're definitely playing. They don't really publicize or stream their locals. So,
I think we've gotten that much fucking spoiled by the privilege of being able to watch anything we want on a stream, as long as it's being provided to us. That when it's not provided to us, we're like, oh, there's no noise. I don't hear anything. Marvel's dead.
Well, Marvel's legitimately dead. There's a difference. That shit died.
I don't know.
Well, it definitely got cut off at the leg. That feels like an entrance.
Yeah,
but
it didn't really die. It's just
it needs a major.
People stopped.
It needs.
I feel like for whatever reason, especially on the East Coast and the Northeast, that there's just some sort of reluctance toward it now. I don't no idea why, but people just kind of seeming to duck the game for all their own reasons, but it's just weird.
I just think it needs like a memorable major performance, something like, you know, that gets people talking about it again and say like, yo, that was actually interesting.
The memorable performance at like Evo wasn't enough, or wasn't even memorable.
I'm not sure how I feel about Evo performances anymore. Nobody's talking about it.
Somebody remarked about the Justin win at Evo as everyone taking it as all's right with the world, we can leave now. Like, order has been restored to the force.
I mean, that's
kind
of what it felt like.
He did a barrel roll, everyone.
Yeah.
He did a barrel roll.
He did.
Yeah, I mean, there's sort of that sort of is that closure. It's like Marvel 3 was a traumatic experience and Justin winning was the closure that you needed to get
past.
Now
we can stop.
But so
I'm sure it'll be fine.
Yeah.
But if you guys want constant videos and information and other media fed to you on a 24/7 news basis, feel free to send me $600 to the following PayPal. Tony, did we make that PayPal yesterday?
No.
Fuck. All right, next week I will have a PayPal address where you can send me money and I will make footage that will not involve a dog yet, but I will get a hype dog. Yeah. You send me another $1,000.
We're going to call it Jenny?
He's going to be Lenny.
Okay.
Lenny the hype dog.
If you just send me videos, or send me money as well.
Send me videos and I will post them for you.
I will. $600. Yeah, give me the videos and the money. I will make videos of Chewy for this hypeness.
Chewy's
a cat, though.
Yeah, see, Chewie's a cat, though.
Chewie's not a cat. God damn it.
See, this is the thing that's bothering me about this. You guys are going about this all wrong. Look, just shoot me money. My PayPal is themanliestchestofall@gmail.com. Send me money. It'll make my life easier. Thank you. That's it.
He's not going to do anything. He's just going to use it, you know, eat stuff.
I mean, yeah. You'd be scheming in the cut.
Not sitting here going to bullshit people. You guys are going to make them videos.
I would.
I would.
No, Alex wouldn't. We all know that. Videos.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like,
hey, I made videos. I just don't release them.
I would just, you know.
For my private use.
See, Gibby, you don't understand me. I'm an avant-garde artist. Like, if it's not up to my level of quality, I don't release these clips.
I don't.
Like, that's not very avant-garde. That's more like, you know, good work ethic.
Avant-garde would be like, guys, we're going to find,
yeah,
like,
avant-garde
20 avant-garde
doesn't give a fuck.
I'm pretty sure avant-garde in this day and age means good work ethic. Does anyone have it anymore?
So when Alex dies, we're going to find 20 mixtapes of him rapping with his bird in a room, and people are going to consider it genius.
And he's going to end each track with, like, yo, this is too good for the world.
So if you guys donate...
Me and my flock come straps with the Glock.
$1,000.
We're done. We're done. The show's over. The show's over.
I have something to say.
All right.
This is actually will be something important since we're trying to close it out. But since we were talking about Mike Z's opinion, you know, and since he's such a great guy, Mockross, thankfully, gave me a post that he made on Skullheart about Exerd. Mm-hmm. So Nightfire is someone that was asked the question. They said, if you like it, then buy it is all well and good for me. But Mike's opinion is relevant that he designs the only fighting game that I currently enjoy playing. It stands to reason that if he likes it, I might like it too. Seems pretty simple to me. No need to get sanctimonious. Mike Z responds, you might like it even if I don't, though. I'm sure many people will. Generally, the problems I notice with your games don't tend to become problems for other people until a decently sized group of players get really good, which takes months or years. It seems like all the Flavor of the Month anime game players will be playing it, as well as the 09ers who said, well, I never played Guilty Gear before, but I'm going to start with Exerd, a decent part of existing Guilty Gear player base, so there'll be people to play in competition of all levels that makes a difference in the enjoyability of any game. It is a valid complaint that people have about Skullgirls, albeit one a developer can't do much to influence. Probably the bit you are looking for. I am not buying it, because I could hold Guilty Gear to the rising standard set by Reload, Slash, to AC, and mostly upheld by AC plus R, in which, in my honest opinion, Exerd does not even come close to continuing. I'm not looking forward to another Guilty Gear with unblockable loops, nor the needlessly new random elements like Danger Time, nor heavy roll option selects already in play thanks to YRCs. But if you won't miss Force Breaks, the way characters played and interacted after the 7 years of refinements, or half the cast not existing, an example, if you are new to Guilty Gear, preferred Reload, then why not? TLDR, if you want to learn Guilty Gear and appreciate a truly amazing design game with a huge character variety and great balance, I would recommend AC plus R. AC's online is bad enough to count as non-existent outside of Japan, unfortunately for us. If you want to learn Guilty Gear and must have online, a valid criterion for some at this point, or you want to play some new games and will surely feature at majors and have large initial player bases, or for some reason you buy games based on the review scores, get Exerd. Look at me, I can predict the future. And then in a spoiler, I didn't list FRCs because I don't miss them. And then Mike Z smiley. Thank you, Mike Z.
And as always, we invite you to question everything anyone ever says.
Right.
So if you want to listen to Mike, feel free. If you think Mike's a dumbass, that's on
you. Feel free.
Feel free to do the same.
If your mom tells you that she loves you, check it out.
Yeah, I would double check. Like, you know, mom's over here saying unconditional love. How can you be sure?
Exactly.
Sounds a little suspect.
Yeah.
Hope like everybody enjoyed SDR this week. Anybody else?
Whatever I got to say, I'll wait till next week.
All right, cool, because I want to watch this Vince McMahon on Stone Cold podcast. So, thanks for listening, everybody. So, from everybody here at Super Desperation Radio, good night. And good luck.